We'll see the Houston Astros as they play against the Los Angeles Angels. And now it's out to Los Angeles with Gary Thorne, John Kruk, and Steve Phillips.
Not often do you see a long ball that is that long, but occasionally that fountain does get visited by the cowhide here in Anaheim. The home field advantage today, will the Angels be able to take advantage of it? Glad to have you join us, Tuesday night edition of Major League Baseball and 2K Sports. Take a look at Anaheim's starter. Well, Steve, what's he going to be conscious of now as he takes a look at these Houston hitters?
A pretty even matchup right here with the quality of the lineup and the quality of the pitcher. And I think it's going to take run support in support of this righty on the mound today to be able to bring away a victory for his team.
Here's the lineup for the Astros. Scouting pick, John, who are we looking at today?
Now, if your dad played in the major leagues, there's a good chance he'll be a success, and that goes for Michael Brantley. Numbers and power aren't going to jump off the charts at you, but he's a guy that can make contact, put the ball in play, and he's still learning the game.
And we've got Fisher in. He's going to lead his team off as we get ready for the first pitch.
Fielder number 21, Derek Fisher.
First pitch to him, a curveball, swung on and missed, 0-1. Takes one off the plate to even the count at one.
He tried to backdoor that pitch, but left it out and away.
Swung on, hit this one towards Trout. That's one away. Got a chance to check out the Angels. Let's see where they're positioning themselves on defense.
As we look at this club defensively, the third best fielding percentage in the American League. And you have to understand how much pressure that takes off a pitching staff. They feel comfortable to throw it over the plate, knowing the plays get made behind them.
So with one away, here's David Ortiz. Smashes that one towards the shortstop. In time for the out.
The Houston Astros designated hitter number 23, Michael Brantley.
And Brantley's in the box. A career 267 number off the Angels. That's on that off-speed pitch, but can't connect, 0-1. Doesn't get the call on the slider, 1-1. Line towards third and foul. Swing and a soft grounder towards second. Number four. Out. Throws on to first, side is retired. And a good defensive half inning. Three up, three down. And the Angels, their first chance coming right up. And doing the pitching, it will be Wade Miley. He'll be Houston's starter. Steve, as he faces these Angel hitters, what's a primary emphasis?
I'll send it a good lefty.
He sends this one in the air towards center. And the leadoff man's on board. You love the offense when it gets going that way. We've got a moment to check the lineup for the Angels. Any of these bats stand out? John?
Why, there isn't anything Albert Pujols can't do in a batter's box. Power, plate discipline. He is the complete package. Even in the on-deck circle, he's still a threat because managers have to figure out a way to manage around him.
Here's a look at how the Astros will match up defensively.
Our defense has been a problem for this club, and when you take a look at the number of errors they've committed, it's in the bottom five in the American League. They just have not been able to make the plays like other teams have to be able to get big outs.
Here's the pitch. Ball! Just missed with the fastball, 1-0. pauses, and now the 1-0. Down and away for ball two. Three, and Mike Trout will stay away from that, and now they are in danger of walking.
A lot of managers are hesitant to turn their guys loose 3-0, but I say let it fly. This might be the best pitch he sees in the whole at bat.
He's ready. The 3-1. 3-1, a fastball swung on and missed. Full count.
Well, if you're going to be late on the fastball, you're going to have trouble hitting up here, and he's struggling right now.
The 3-2 pitch. And on that one, he'll up his base percentage. That's ball four.
Patience really paid off there, and it paid big dividends now if somebody comes up with a big hit.
Well, you know, the pitcher's really tired right now, and you have to think that his confidence is a little bit shaken. That long at bat right there, he had a chance to put the hitter away, and now he has to go from the stretch to try to keep this inning from getting out of hand.
Runners at first and second, nobody out. This one's pretty well hit to deep left center. Around third, heading home. Can't cut it off. It's going to roll to the wall. And he will score from second base. And Trout will score as well. And he'll stop at second base. That'll be a two-run double. Those two RBIs, boy, that makes a difference. We can see just how much on this WPA chart.
The defense needs to stop right now. They need to put up an out here. This offense has been relentless this inning.
So a runner in scoring position for Albert Pujols. You know, Steve, they needed to take the lead, and they've come through just as we thought they might. See how this plays out.
Well, we all knew the possibility of getting some early runs up early could happen here. That was possible. This could turn out to be a very interesting game, guys.
Pulls that one off, and it's high. Ball one. And, guys, it'll be interesting to see how the rest of this inning plays out. Sometimes not easy to contain a lineup once it gets started. It's infectious.
Well,
he swings down, really hit that. That's going to one hop off the wall. A run scores. Probably thinking about the matchups here as we check the bullpen. Left-handers throw it.
Oh, that's right. I think they're getting loosened up to face the hitter in the on-deck circle.
This is a guy right here that was made to hit fastballs, and that's what he looks for, and that's what he got right there. Put a good swing on it. He knew what to do with it for that double.
Ball. First pitch is a sinker, too low, 1-0. You know, this is a kind of an interesting breakdown. You take a look at the pitch types that were thrown that have been hit for a base hit or better.
This guy's four-seamer's been hit twice already.
Well, you can definitely feel for him right now. A lot of runs up on the board here in the first inning. And command issues, especially on certain pitches, have been a central focus for him so far. He's going to have to find a pitch to get somebody out and regroup.
Here it comes. Fastball can't catch the corner. He's behind 3-0. Put a base runner on. That's ball four.
By trying to expand the strike zone to get the hitter to chase. Good discipline didn't do it. Now he's on first.
And we've got LaCroix now coming to the plate.
Well, this inning getting worse right now. I mean, listen, second walk of this inning, giving up a bunch of runs, so clearly he can't be long for this game.
No one out yet. Runners at first and second. Boy, he scorched that one. That was right over the mound. That's one out. And a deuce, a double play. Execution on that 6-4-3.
Got that body control around the bag. Great acrobatic turn by the second baseman. Outstanding job.
Goodwin up now. swung on, line to right center field. That's down. The run's coming in.
They tried to deceive him, but they couldn't. They pulled the string on that changeup, but he kept his hands back and still was able to put a pretty good swing on it.
In the box, their rookie second baseman. One player picking up after another, Steve. This is a good offensive show going on, and they're climbing the ladder with it.
Gary, it's still early in this game, but there's a chance this could get out of reach even before we get out of this inning.
And a classic here, maybe one of these stop the bleeding scenarios right going on. Swings at that first delivery. Curveball by him on one.
Well, classic stop the bleeding, but not classic pitching so far. This offense taking advantage of the opportunities.
The pitch. And he's out in front on that pitch, so he's in the hole now, 0-2.
He must not have eaten for a long time because he was hungry for this pitch. Problem was, it's a pretty good slider. You swing that hard at a slider, pretty good chances you're going to come up empty.
You're out. Bring him up, strike three. But boy, what a solid offensive inning that was. Now that's the kind of first inning you want. Big early runs, and Anaheim is ahead 4-0. In there, their first baseman.
Number 10.
Sliders in there for a called strike. Oh, and he lays off the fastball. Good pitch, 1-1.
Well, that pitch right there just seemed to get away from the pitcher, took off on him. Looked like he tried to overthrow that a little bit.
It's fouled off. Slider tough to lay off, and it's 2-2. That one swung on, hit in the air to deep right center field. And Trout gets to it.
Right fielder, number 22, Josh Reddick.
Now batting with one away, Josh Reddick.
Teams relished when the Astros came into town last year. 30 games under 500 on the road, a big-time struggle.
Takes a swing at that fastball, can't connect, 0-1. Well, how about that Houston performance on the road? They won only 9 games away from Minute Maid Park, John. That's almost undoable.
Yeah, but in the second half, the Astros were already so far out of it. They were playing a lot of young guys, using different lineups. That would have made the difference under any circumstance.
Fletcher. Out, two away.
The Houston Astros. Catcher, number 28, Robinson Chirino.
And Chirino's batting. This one's grounded to second. Number 4. And he throws on to first. That'll retire the side. Good defensive half inning there. No hits allowed. The Astros unable to get on the board. Fletcher up now. He'll get things started here in the home half of the second.
David Fletcher.
Perez coming in now to pitch. They've decided it's time to bring a new arm into this one. And he misses high. Perez can't get him to go after that one. Curve is in the strike zone, even at 1. Here's the delivery. 1-1 delivery. A fastball taken for a strike. 1-2. changeup, misses. 2-2. Now the 2-2. Slider just about had him. 3-2 count.
That's a tough pitch for a hitter. That breaking ball that he's burying toward the back foot, tough to lay off.
Hit in the air to center field. Kemp will field. What a way.
Los Angeles Angels of England. Third base. Number 9.
And it rolls around to the top again.
You know, to be successful, you have to be good within your own division. Last year, the Angels just 27-30 against the rest of the AL West.
And starts him out here. This one fouled back. We're talking about the Angels, that sub 500 record against the West, playing Texas 19 times. That makes it very, very tough in that division, John.
Absolutely. The Texas team last year was one that you would have liked to play as few times as possible, and the Halos didn't handle those matchups very well.
And he misses high. Perez can't get him to go after that one. The 2-1 pitch. Low for a ball, and it's suddenly 3-1.
But if you're going to miss, this is where you want to miss. Throw that breaking ball at the bottom of the strike zone. If the hitter swings and puts it in play, it's a ground ball out.
The pitch. Ball four. He walked it.
He can throw a slider in that location, but he just missed with that one.
That will bring up Mike Trout. He walked and later scored his last time through. He deals. Sliders in there, no balls and a strike. Here's the delivery, and that's a strike. Nick Trout now is going to have to take a don't-get-struck-out defensive stance here.
He gets two quick strikes on the hitter, but he can't be too selective now. He's got to go right at him.
Slider misses, and it's 1-2 now.
He tried to backdoor that pitch, but left it out and away.
Good eye, Mike Trout. He'll stay away from that one. That'll even up the count. He's ready. The 2-2 pitch.
Full three.
Changeup misses. Full 3-2.
Well, that pitch right there, that changeup away. If a guy's looking for it, that's a great pitch to be able to hit the other way with some power.
Here's the 3-2 pitch. Line shot into center field. And it's through. That's going to be a base hit for Trout. Boy, what a time now to capitalize if they can.
A real good approach at the plate right here, thinking about going back up the middle. He gets a fastball a little bit inside, but able to just punch it up the middle for a base hit.
Number 3 slot up again here. He doubled home a couple in his last at bat. Runners on first and second with one out. Swing and lined up the middle. And that one is in there, his second hit today. That's going to bring up Albert Pujols.
A real pressure mounting right now. That base hit loads up the bases.
He's going to have to make a pitch to try to get out of this mess.
Well, I think we're seeing some padding here, although in this game there's no such thing as insurance, really.
You got the pitcher on the rope. You have to take advantage of it while he's down.
And the first pitch. Watches that outside pitch from Perez. It'll be a ball. Now, it's hard to believe the pitcher could get himself into this kind of situation of all people to have up there, Albert Pujols.
You don't want to walk him, but there's not another guy in baseball that scares you more than Albert Pujols at the plate.
Watches that fastball go by, and now he's at 1-2.
Well, like a lot of hitters with two strikes, he's been very susceptible to the breaking ball. Let's see if he gets it.
And Pujols watches that one go by. Count is even.
Well, a lot of guys would swing at that pitch right there, that changeup down in the strike zone, but the hitter luckily stayed off that one.
The pitch. Strike three. Albert Pujols swings and misses. He's turned away.
With two strikes, the hitter wanted the fastball. He got it, but didn't do anything with it.
Right fielder up. Threw a walk his last time. Curveball just misses. 1-0. The 1-0 now. Here's a swing and a ground ball. Oh, he's going to try to make the play. Throws on to first in time to retire the side. Well, they do load the bases on two hits, but can't push across any runs. And we'll see the Astros coming up next. Bottom three due up next.
The place for the Houston Astros.
And we've got Kemp batting.
Number
He'll get things going here in the third.
Kemp.
That's off the plate away, 1-0. Here's a swing and a ground ball. Fletcher. One away now. Number eight spot in the lineup. This is his first chance at bat. Pitch, curveball, swung out and missed, 0-1. The 0-1 pitch, a fastball high, 1-1.
Well, that's just some good old country hardball right there. Four-seam fastball up in the zone.
He takes a fastball for a strike. Now it's 1-2.
Well, that's a hittable pitch right there, Gary. A fastball in the inner part of the plate. But if you're looking out over the plate, sometimes it freezes you.
Slider swung out and missed. Two down.
Well, that's a lot of movement there for a pitch at 87 miles per hour. Good pitch right at the knees there. He swung right over the top of it and just couldn't put it in play.
And it's the number nine spot. Fastball is in there. It's 0-1. miss at that fastball. No balls, two strikes. Swung on, bounced weakly to second. Number four. Throws on to first, side is retired. And a good half inning there, gone in short order in this one. The shutout continues in L.A. And we've got LaCroix now coming to the plate.
Number 20.
By time, 231 off the Astros. Now swinging a shot toward second. In time for the out.
Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim. Left fielder, number 18, Ryan Goodwin.
Goodwin is the batter now. Had an RBI single his last time to the plate. Now the first pitch. He takes that one. Perez has him on one.
That fastball just froze him on the inside corner. Now we're going to see where he goes. Look for something soft, possibly away.
Let's go, Angels. Here we go.
This is popped down the right field line. Should be room.
Oh!
And at first that one was going to look playable, but nothing doing. It got away. Swing and a miss. Slider, two down.
Good chance to take a look at this slider right here, Gary.
Number four.
Now he helped him right there with two strikes. He gets the slider, but he chases it out of the zone for strike three.
And the number eight spot rolls around. He was a strikeout victim last time through the lineup. Here we go. Here's the first pitch. This is swung on, lifted to deep right field. And Reddick grabs that one, and the side's retired. No runs, no hits. Nobody crossed the plate in this half inning, and nobody left on base. Angels 4, Houston nothing.
Coming to bat for the Houston.
And we've got Fisher in. He'll start things off here, inning number 4.
Garrett Fisher.
Change up in there for a called strike.
Now, Gary, they're going through the lineup the second time around right here. They don't have any hits, so they've really got to start thinking about what are they doing at the plate and should they be more aggressive right now.
He lets that fastball go by for a called strike, 0-2. Wanted to get him fishing, but he misses 1-2.
He tried to backdoor that pitch, but left it out and away.
Curveball. Where did that miss? 2-2. Steve, let's take a look and see how that pitcher's done today.
You know, when he's throwing the ball down on the zone like this, these lefty hitters have to stay behind the ball to drive it. They just don't seem able to do that. They keep swinging and hitting the top part of the ball.
That misses below the knees. That'll run us to the full 3-2 count.
Well, that fastball right there just missed, just below the knees. Tell you what, a borderline pitch. I think they wanted that one bad.
Hit on the ground towards second. Number four. Throw on to first in time.
He's retired 10 in a row. The hitters are completely overmatched right now. He's got it all going on.
So with one away, here's David Ortiz. 0 for 1 thus far. There's a swing and a ball hit deep to right field. Still going back. Goodbye, it's gone. Home run. The Astros are on the board with a big fly. Still down by 3 runs with that homer, but maybe some steam going here.
One step at a time for the Astros. They've narrowed the margin, getting a little bit closer. Who knows what can happen from here?
First pitch, and he misses the fastball, strike one. Great production, Steve. The long ball changes the complexion of a game so often.
It sure does. You know, with this kind of power, you can catch up quickly.
Strike looks two. At a fastball in there, and it's quickly 0-2. And a moment here to see how this pitcher has been mixing up his pitches.
Yeah, the thing about it is he's keeping his team in the game, and aside from a few mistakes he's thrown, he's done a pretty good job of mixing things up.
Yeah, it's been fairly consistent in this game. The variety of pitches has been good, and most importantly, his choice of when to go with a certain pitch has been effective.
Well, you have an 0-2 count, and that pitcher comes up in the strike zone. You know he's looking for that strikeout. Now you've taken a little bit of confidence away from him with the fact that you can foul that pitch up in the zone off to live to see another day.
Makes its way through for a single. Now Steve, looked back. Like that was a strike. Ball was up high, but I think in the zone.
Well, up and away, but on an 0-2 count, you're thinking, I need to make contact. Exceptional job of eye-hand coordination.
And the first baseman in. Last time up, flew up. And the first pitch, that's inside for a ball, 1-0. Changing the eye level of hitters is such a key component. Here we can see the breakdown of how this guy has been mixing locations.
Well, you can see with the success he's having, and the numbers prove it. He's stayed consistently tricky throughout this.
Boy, that one is stung up the middle. The second for one, and two, double play. Narrow their deficit a bit. They pick up a run on the day. Houston trying to get back to a position to challenge. Just tuning in. Hi, Gary Thorne along with John Crutch, Steve Phillips. We bring you Major League Baseball on 2K Sports. Fletcher in the box now. He's ready to start the home half here in the fourth inning. He takes that one. Perez has him 0-1.
Well, against this guy in this situation, Gary, you've got to go with the changeup.
Swung on, hit. Oh, man, was that close. That was right back. Him somehow get out of the way, and so there he is at first base, and there's still nobody out.
Number nine.
Well, good piece of hitting right there, and anytime you get your first hitter of the inning on base, it could set up the potential for a big inning.
In the box, their third baseman, he's 1-for-1 so far.
He's got the lead right now with speed on first base. You have to get him going, I think, Gary. Keep the pressure on. Keep trying to tack on some runs.
And the first pitch was a strike. Got him at 0-1 right now. On the way. Strike two at the knees. Nothing and two.
Down, down, down. It's all about location. That breaking ball down in the zone makes it very difficult on the hitter.
Two-strike pitch, misses high, 1-2.
Now, 1-2 is a pitcher's count, so there's no reason to give him a good pitch to hit right here.
The 1-2 on its way. Slider, 2-2.
Now, if you're going to miss, this is where you want to miss. Throw that breaking ball at the bottom of the strike zone. If the hitter swings and puts it in play, it's a ground ball out.
Fouled off. Big swing and a miss on a heater. Strike him out, one down.
Well, two strikes on the hitter. He came inside. He just couldn't catch up quickly enough to it. He must have been thinking away.
And it's Mike Trout now, one away. Had a base hit his last time up.
Hello.
Here's the first pitch. Ball. Fastball, too low, 1-0. Ready with a 1-0. That's a foul ball.
Foul!
Here's the 1-1 pitch. There's a swing and a liner. And he gets it down. He's 2-for-2 now. Boy, they've opened the door. Can Anaheim go through it?
When you're a hitter and you see that ball pouring in on you on the inside part of the plate, all you can do is hope to get some piece of bat on it to get that hit. He got jammed, fought it off, but a great piece of hitting.
One out with runners at first and second. Fastball taken high, 1-0.
Oh, he tried that four-seam fastball up in the zone to get him the chase. Tough pitch to lay off of. Good job by the hitter.
Can't connect with that fastball. Now it's 1-1.
Get a little extra giddy up on that one as he just blows it right by him.
Swing and a miss, and he's behind 1-2.
Well, anytime you recognize a slider, you got to be very patient with it. You can't be over-anxious. You got to stay back, and then when you see it good enough, let it fly.
Here's the pitch. And it's fouled away. One-two pitch coming. Line drive, that's foul towards first.
Well, what you're looking for when you're behind in the count is you hope the pitcher makes a mistake. In this case, though, he didn't. He made a great pitch.
Swing, a high drive down the left field line. It is gone. Goodbye home run for the Angels, and their offense is on track. Stevie knocks in a three-run homer. They lead by six. Little warm-up action going in the bullpen. That's a right-hander up and throwing.
Well, they're going to wait for the right-handed hitter on deck to get announced, and then they'll probably make the move to the pen. No, he just didn't throw that slider where he wanted it to. And sometimes those pitches back up, and it can be dangerous if you leave it out over the plate. Now, this is what the Angels need, Gary. They want hits to continue to add to this lead.
Number five, Albert Pujols.
Swung on and missed. Strike one. And Steve, they're starting to run away here. Even though it's early in the ballgame, the offense putting real pressure on the pitching.
Well, taking advantage of the mistakes by the pitching staff and capitalizing on it. And when they get back out there, they need their pitcher to put up zeros.
Called strike and it's 0-2.
He let that four-seam fastball go up and in the zone. It's up in his eyes. You can see it well. He just couldn't pull the trigger.
And he watches ball one. The 1-2 pitch. That's hit foul by Pujols. Hit in the dirt. Number 10. And they'll record the out at first base. Good timing on that play.
He might not have been able to get him out at the plate, but a short run over to first, and still retires his new one.
And the right fielder batting again. Grounded out his last time through. And here's the first one. Fastball in there, 0-1.
Some guys really like the low fastball. In this situation, though, he ends up taking the pitch.
Oh, one offering from Perez. Fastball misses low that time, 1-1. Perez throws to first in time. That's three down. Well, that didn't come too soon. 25 pitches to get out of the inning. The Angels dominating this ballgame. It's running at the plate. These at-bats, how's he starting them? Let's take a look.
You throw strike one, you get out.
Ground ball. And Pujols fields it. And out. Pitcher makes a nice play at first base.
That was a nice play. Saw the opportunity at first and waste any time getting over. That's the key. Beat the runner to the back.
Good hustle off the mound. And Chirinos batting. Ground out victim last time through. On that curveball, it's 0-1. Oh! That one is going to miss. Low for a ball, 1-1. Strike 1-2 the count. Here's a swing and a fly ball to right center. And it's in there. He's got himself a base hit.
He takes this 1-2 pitch down in the zone. He's able to go down and get it. Get a good part of the bat on the ball and pick up the base hit.
That's a tough pitch to hit. When you're behind in the count, you just want contact, and he got it. And we've got Kemp batting. 0 for 1 thus far. Here's the first pitch. Cut on and missed, 0-1.
Well, if you're going to get a good fastball, you better pull the trigger a little sooner. You can't be late on that heater.
Here's the delivery. And that misses for a ball. The pitch, strike two with a swing and a miss on a fastball. Here's a swing and a ground ball. A moment here for Houston if they can execute.
Shortstop, number 9.
He goes right with the pitch and slaps the ball into left field.
And if you try and pull that pitch, you're probably not even going to get the bat on it.
That's a ground ball to second base if he pulls that one.
Runners on first and second with one out. And here's the first one. Line, foul towards third. And here's the pitch. Misses for a ball to even things at one.
Well, that's where you look for a changeup from the pitcher away in the strike zone. If they look for it and get it, they can really shoot that thing the other way and do some damage.
He sends this one in the air towards center. Two down here in the inning.
Standing up to the plate for the Houston Astros.
Now there, center fielder.
A bit of a break here right now, Gary. The fact that there aren't runners on base, but this guy tends to struggle a little bit at the plate.
Here's the pitch. Smacked that one. He got it right up the middle. That looks like a single.
Well, an outstanding piece of hitting to load the bases. Picks up that single, and now the pressure mounts.
And we've got Fisher in. Well, he's got an opportunity here. He can be a hero. You get an extra base hit, you're going to score some runs.
Well, you don't know how many opportunities you're going to get later in the game. You have to take advantage of this one. If you're going to make a comeback, now's the time to start.
Now the first pitch.
Foul!
That one goes foul. Pitch on the way. Called strike below the waist, and he's in the hole now, 0-2.
A good late break, hard break on that breaking pitch. Outstanding effort.
Let's go, Angels. Here we go.
Waist one there, 1-2. The big bender struck him outside, retired. Well, they load the bases on the strength of three base hits, but no runs. The Angels still enjoying this lead. And we've got LaCroix now coming to the plate.
Number 20, Jonathan LaCroix.
Perez with the delivery. Can't get him to chase it. That's low, ball one.
Well, he tried to change up right there, but it just stayed down and off the plate.
Now the 1-0 pitch. Swing and a miss, one strike. One on the way. Missed that one. One ball, two strikes. Ball swung out and missed, struck him out, one away.
Now we're going to get a chance, Gary, to see the four-seam fastball in KK.
Number 18.
Well, he just looked overpowered on those two fastballs.
John thought the timing that time just didn't seem to be there in the at-bat.
Well, and a strikeout like that will give the pitcher a lot of confidence.
Goodwin settling in. Struck out swinging his last time up. The first pitch. That catches the outer part of the plate for a strike.
Well, this is what they need to do right now is retire a leadoff man. You can't let a leadoff man keep getting on because they keep coming around to score.
There's a swing, line drive, center field. And it gets down. That's hit number two, making good contact.
A one out and a man on first base. That big single right there gives them a couple outs to work with to see if they can push him across the board.
Up now, their second baseman. 0 for 2 thus far. He delivers. Swing and a line to left. And that's through a base hit.
A good piece of hitting right here. They shift the defense to the right. He says, fine, I'll go left.
Base hit.
Fletcher, it's a turn here.
I'm sure they didn't set out thinking, hey, let's pitch all our bullpen guys this early in the game. What do you think, Gary? I don't know. They need this guy to hold down the fort and see if he can't give them some innings.
He singled and later scored in his last time up. 1 for 2 in the ballgame. Took something off, and it swung on and missed, 0-1.
Boy, he just couldn't wait for that changeup to get in the strike zone. You can't try to chase it. You have to let it come to you.
Slider locked him up. He's behind 0-2.
Well, they cannot allow a base hit here, and certainly not an extra base hit. You've got a double play waiting to happen here. Get the ground ball out.
Swings and grounds this one foul, wide of third. Fastball misses inside, and it's 1-2 now.
Well, they threw that pitch right there down and in, just off the plate. Let's see if they come back with another fastball down and away.
The 1-2 on its way. Changeup called, strike three. That's the second out.
KK shows 83 miles per hour and a very straight pitch.
I think he's upset that he let that one go by.
Well, he should be, Gary. I mean, that was a perfectly good pitch to hit. He just didn't pull the trigger.
And it rolls around to the top again.
Well, it gets a little bit of a break here in a jam with runners on base, but a guy who not typically is a very good hitter in this situation.
Two down. Runners at first and second. Here's the first pitch. Tatsy Mott for the pitch on the outside corner. Strike one.
Well, clearly the pitcher's in control right here. This guy really struggles on the fastball when he's behind in the count, so look for the heat.
Here it comes. The second pitch cuts on a fastball, misses, and it's 0-2.
Two outs in the inning here, but runners on first and second. You've got to knock the ball down in the infield. Don't let it get to the outfield where they can pick up another run and see if he can get a force out at one of the bases.
This one's bounced up the middle. Kemp. He'll throw on to first, and that'll do it for this half inning. So, no runs, two hits, and they strand two. Angels 7, Houston 1. David Ortiz leads it off. Well, it's keeping up with the hit trends in this one. Let's take a look at the pitches that he's thrown on the mound that have been put in play.
That four-seam fastball of his, it's gotten hit three times.
You know, it's a bit concerning how he's been hit when he's gone to that pitch. But you can't be too disappointed with how he's come out and pitched in this one. He's definitely given his team a chance to win.
Watches that fastball go by, and now he's at 1-2.
He's painting the black away with that fastball, Gary, hitting the spots and with great velocity.
Got him. One away.
Here's the slider coming right at you in KK. Get a better look at that.
Well, sometimes you get fooled so badly, there's just nothing else you can do but hope and pray that you put the ball in play, hopefully foul, to get another pitch to hit.
And Bradley's in the box. He singled in his last at bat. Line shot into center field, and now Trout gloves it, puts it away. Cleanup man in the box again. Now, one of the keys to a successful day on the mound. Can you generate strikes going outside the strike zone? Here's a look at what we've seen today.
Well, he's been very effective today, and you look at the performance, he's generating strikes with pitches out of the zone, getting the hitters to chase.
Oh, absolutely, Steven. You know, you want to try to expand the strike zone. You start in the strike zone early, and then try to make...
Hit sharply towards the hole. Throws to first, side is retired. It's called short work of three. Took six pitches. The Angels still enjoying this lead. For two in the game.
Number 27 is Mike Trout.
First pitch on the way. There's a ground ball. Kemp. One down.
Number 17.
Up again there, DH. He is just a triple shy of the cycle now.
Well, it's the toughest leg of the cycle to get, but if he hits it into the gap, look at him run.
The pitch. First pitch, a fastball. That's in there for a strike.
Well, this is what you need to do. You need to put up some zeros right now. Get some out and get your fielders back in the dugout to swing the bat and try to make up this deficit.
Too far inside, 1-1.
Well, that pitch just took off right there and exploded out of the pitcher's hand. Kept it just a little bit inside, though. Tough pitch to hit. Good job by the hitter to lay off.
The 1-1. This one's blasted. High, deep, center field, way back there. It is gone. Goodbye home run for the Angels, and their offense is on track. What an offensive display here today. Another big fly. The lead now to 7.
That's his second home run of the day right there. He's locked in, Gary.
That means he's seeing the baseball team. And it's Albert Pujols now with one away.
Perfect. Number 5, Albert Pujols.
And the first pitch. Swing, liner, back up the middle. And in there, second hit for him in the ball game in his fourth plate appearance.
All he can do as a pitcher and catcher is put down the side and pitch to a guy's weakness. That's what they did right there. That pitch down and away, an excellent pitch, but a better job of execution by the hitter.
Up again now, the number 5 spot. Grounded out last time. Here we go. Here's the first pitch. First pitch, fastball, 0-1. Here's the pitch. Plays off the changeup. Good pitch, but it's 1-1.
Well, that pitch right there, that changeup away, if the guy's looking for it, that's a great pitch to be able to hit the other way with some power.
Comes set, now the 1-1. Foul fastball, now the count 1-2.
When you can spot your four-seam fastball to the outside corner, the hitter has to have balance at the plate and not pull off the ball.
The 1-2 pitch. Fastball got him, 2-2.
Here's the four-seam fastball coming at you in K-Cam. You better look.
Two straight fastballs, he still couldn't catch up with him.
Well, the pitcher comes back with a fastball right after he threw one and gets the K. You know he's throwing gas out there.
And we've got LaCroix now coming to the plate. Pujols, your runner at first. Here's the first pitch. Check swing here. They say he did not go around the appeal to first. No, he did not, so he will continue this at bat. Slider just misses the black, falls behind 2-0. Fastball can't catch the corner. He's behind 3-0. Swinging on the 3-0 slider. He missed it, 3-1.
Well, this one here was no doubt about it. The late break on that slider. I mean, what a devastating pitch, and the hitter just couldn't catch up.
There's a check swing, and it evens the count at 2. It's in there. The full count pitch. There's a swing and a liner towards the gap in left field. And he gets his first base hit. Well, is he going to be happy to see that crowd over with? This has been a tough game.
Well, absolutely no bite to that slider right there. He kept it out over the plate. The hitter got a good whack at it.
Goodwin is the batter. 2-for-3 thus far. Here's the pitch. And he takes the ball, 1-0.
He tried to backdoor that pitch, but left it out and away.
Here's the 1-0. That's a called strike on the other half, 1-1.
Sometimes when the pitch comes out of the pitcher's hand, you have to say to yourself, I'm going to lay off and wait for the next one. He didn't think he could catch up to it. Good decision.
Lays off that, ball 2. Now the 2-1. This one's popped up behind the plate. Changeup just about had him, but it's full now. Three-two on the way. And that misses. Ball 4. He is loaded him up.
Well, you just saw a great deal of plate discipline right there on the hitter. Maybe a little fatigue on the pitcher's part. They're not used to throwing that many pitches in one at bat, but the hitter wins it and gets that base on balls.
And the number 8 spot rolls around, and he'll be looking to pad the lead a bit here.
When you get these kinds of opportunities, you have to capitalize on it to swing the bat.
And the pitcher's really got to bear down now. Here's the first pitch.
Strike one!
Can't connect, it's 0-1.
He just swung late on that one. That's what you call getting gassed up.
Pitch on the way. 0-1 is a fastball inside. That'll even the count at 1. A 1-1 now. Good looking fastball. Call the ball though. 2-1. Now the 2-1 pitch. 3-1 now.
Well, the hitter's not a big threat at the plate right here, so the last thing you want to do is go 3-0, but that's what he did. Now, look, he's probably going to take 1, possibly 2 strikes. You got to throw it over the plate and make him hit it.
Hot shot towards the hole. Kemp. And he throws on to first. That'll retire the side. Take a look down there in the bullpen. They've got a lefty up and throwing.
Well, I don't see it coming in just yet. I mean, with a righty in the on-deck circle, I don't think that's the matchup they want.
So they pick up a run on the home run and add to their lead. The Angels dominating this ballgame.
Now up to the plate.
And here's Josh Reddick leading it off. 0-for-2 thus far.
Josh Reddick.
Fastball misses away. 1-0.
Look, Gary, with this big a lead here in the seventh inning, it's incumbent upon the pitcher to throw strikes, get outs right now.
Ball!
1-0 on the way. And that's off the plate, away, ball 2. And he checks his swing. They say he didn't go around, but they're going to appeal down to third. Well, obviously not the call they were fishing for, so we'll try it again. Pitchers hate giving him up, and he's going to do that there. That's ball 4.
Now it's quite a battle, and he hates to lose this one. Those free passes can come back to haunt you. Plus the pitching coach in the dugout counting your pitches right now.
Little warm-up action going in the bullpen. That's a right-hander up and throwing.
Well, they're going to wait for the right-handed hitter on deck to get announced, and then they'll probably make the move to the pen.
And there's a called strike.
A nice location with that fastball down in the zone. If he makes contact, it's going to be a ground ball.
Here's the pitch. That misses, 1-1.
Ball 2. strike two.
Curveball drops in for a strike. He's even at two. Now the 2-2 pitch.
Oh!
It's fouled off. He picks it up. And there's one. And two. They got both of them that time.
They have to love great defense. I mean, that's an unbelievable effort right there. And a way to pick the team up in a critical situation.
And it gets the fans into the game, too. I think fans love D. And we've got Kemp batting. 1-for-2 in the ballgame. Swing and a miss. Strike one.
Well, it's getting late right now. Two outs here in the seventh inning, and, you know, they're down by a bunch of runs. They need to start to get something going right here, Gary.
Oh!
That's hit foul by Kemp.
Oh!
Kemp again fouling it off.
Well, the battle starts when you step in the batter's box, but the real battle starts when the count is 0-2, and that's where he sees himself. But giving credit, he's keeping himself alive by fouling off that tough 0-2 pitch on the outside part of the plate. Let's see if he can make the pitcher make a mistake.
Fletcher batting now. He'll start the home half of the seventh.
Number six.
Well, it's always nice to have a defensive replacement coming off the bench and holding a lead or holding a deficit and giving yourself a chance to win. Now he needs to come up with a big play.
And he hits a base hit in the center.
Now up to the
plate. That's hit number 15 in them for that one. And boy, you get 50 hits in the game. The manager can just sit back and relax and watch his team work.
And it rolls around to the top again. And he gets into the Angels lineup now, John. What about what he's thinking about?
Aaron Heilman had to reinvent himself. After he got traded in 2009 to the Cubs, they made him go up top of his delivery. It used to be a three-quarter slider, but what that did, it let the hitter see the ball way too long. He had some success early throwing the ball over top, but then it got kind of lazy and he got hit around late in the season. If he can continue to find that consistent slot, he can be an effective pitcher because he has great stuff. Boy, anytime you bring in a relief pitcher to come in a key situation, the last thing you want to do is for him to serve one up to the first hitter. That's exactly what he did, giving up that big base hit.
Trout at the plate, grounded out last time. Runners at first and second. Nobody out. And he starts him out. Slider just misses. 1-0.
He went for the backdoor slider right there, but he laid off the pitch. Good eye.
This one's grounded foul. Wide at first. Here's a spin and a throw back to second. And he's back easily. Made a dive to get in. The pitch. And he looks at a fastball in there, and it's 1-2 now.
Hitters have to have great balance and be prepared for the pitch away. If you open up even a little bit, you can't catch up to that four-seam fastball on the outside corner.
1-2 pitch coming. And Mike Trout comes up empty with that swing, strike three, and that sets him down.
Well, you can hang laundry on that one. 94 miles per hour, pretty good velocity, but that's pretty straight.
Number three slot up again here. He is just a triple shy of the cycle now.
Well, it's the toughest leg of the cycle to get, but if he hits it into the gap, look at him run.
First pitch to him. Off the plate with a fastball, and it's 1-0.
Well, they need somebody to get out of an inning without giving up runs. And, you know, I got a shot right here to do it, but you're going to need a double play ball. And I tell you what, if they don't get out of this inning, I don't think they can come back, Gary.
Swing and a liner to right center. And he gets it down yet again. A five-hit game. What a performance.
And that is hit number five in this ball game for him. Have a day, young man.
Here's Albert Pujols now with the RBI chance. And the bases are loaded for him.
And I tell you what, they've been swinging the bat so well in this game. One more hit right here, and this thing is over.
This is a big lead already. Bases are loaded here with only one away. There's a swing and a ground ball. Up with it now. That's one. And they get it. They turn two. They pick up three hits in the inning. They leave the Sox four. The Angels 8, Houston 1.
For the Houston Astros.
The rookie shortstop in. He'll lead it off here. Inning number 8. Change up just misses. 1-0.
It's getting late right now. They're down a bunch, so they need a big inning here. They can't wait till the ninth to try to come all the way back. They need to try to do something now.
Ball 1-0 pitch. A changeup stays outside. 2-0.
Well, he's over the 80 pitch mark right now at this point in the game. And you know that pitching coach is keeping a close eye on him to see if he tires.
Swings and misses the breaking ball, and it's 2-1. And that's fine, 2-2. Off on that slider, and it's 3-2.
When you throw a breaking ball like this, you want to start it on the corner and break it off the zone, trying to get the hitter to chase. The hitter didn't take the bait here.
Refuses to go after it. Yes, ball four.
Well, after a long, epic battle, this at-bat ends in a walk. Are you kidding me? Someone should have got struck out, or someone should have got a hit, but the hitter will take the walk.
Now there's center fielder at the plate.
I'll tell you what, this is one of those decisions you can go either way. He's pitched pretty well to this point, but it is getting late. Do you want to take any chances? The manager decides to go to the pen.
He singled his last trip. 1-for-2 in the ballgame. Foul straight back. Lays off that fastball, and it's 0-2.
When you throw the fastball, that's where you want it to go. Now you can elevate a pitch next time around.
There's a swing, and that one's hit on the ground. And he's out at first. Good hustle by the pitcher getting off the mound.
That's a good heads-up play. When you have to know the hitter and his speed. Don't hesitate. Get over and beat him to the bag.
And we've got Fisher in. Struck out swinging last time. One out with the runner at second. Here's the delivery. And he offers at the knuckle curve and misses. 0-1.
Well, I tell you what, you get a knuckleball and you try to want to hit it as far as you can. It's coming so slow. You got to be a little more patient. You got out in front a little too early.
Oh! Looks at a ball. 1-1.
But Gary, the numbers seem to indicate he likes to go fastball on a 1-1 count, trying to get back ahead again.
Watches ball 2. Back up the middle. That one gets through for a base hit. Now we're going to get to see David Ortiz.
But there's no reason in the world for any hitter to want to swing at that pitch. A pitch down out of the strike zone. Never had a chance at all to be a strike. But that's why we're up here talking about it, and he's down there doing it. He can get his bat on that ball to get a hit.
had a home run back in the fourth inning. First pitch on the way.
Strike one.
The 0-0 delivery, a fastball taken for a strike. Swung on and missed, strike two.
This pitcher being very aggressive throwing strikes. I think he's going to try to get him to chase.
Fastball got him looking, two down.
Now we're going to get a chance, Gary, to see the four-seam fastball and kick him.
As a hitter, you've got to recognize early on that this is going to be a tough to reach. You just need to try to lay the bat head out there and at best, foul it off.
Yeah, just that's just a very pretty pitch, John.
Yeah, and it really fooled him, too.
And Brantley's in the box. We'll try it again here, just one for three thus far. Two men on, two men out. Here's the delivery. Hit sharply towards the hole. Throws to first, side is retired. They pick up no runs on a hit, and they lead 2-1. Angels still enjoying the advantage. Middle of the lineup, due up.
Now back.
And the right fielder batting again. He'll get us started as we go to the bottom half of the eighth inning. Here's the pitch. He's off that one outside, 1-0.
Well, he tried to go outside on the outside corner with that fastball right there. Just got a little bit off the plate. He's got to be careful, though. You don't want that hitter to get his arms extended.
1-1.
But, Gary, the numbers seem to indicate he likes to go fastball on a 1-1 count trying to get back ahead again.
Hit in the air to center field. And he makes the catch, one down.
Number 20, Jonathan.
And we've got LaCroix now coming to the plate. He's had one hit, four times up. And the first pitch. That fastball that goes by him for a strike.
This is the go-to pitch for many pitchers in the major league. The fastball down and away. When in doubt, that's where you go.
The pitch. There's a slider that misses. 1-1.
Got nobody on base right now with one out. That's what you need. You need outs and maybe a break from base runners for a little bit here. How about a quick inning to get back in and score some runs?
Can't connect there. Ball and two strikes. Here it comes. Swings and grounds this one to the right side. Foul. The 1-2 on its way. Head up the middle. Whoa, get out of the way of that one. Straight back up the middle. And he pulls into first base with that base hit. There's one down here.
He takes his 1-2 pitch down in the zone. He's able to go down and get it. Get a good part of the bat on the ball and pick up the base hit.
That's a tough pitch to hit. When you're behind in the count, you just want contact, and he got it. Goodwin is up now. Drove in a run earlier in the game. Here's the first one. Shot towards the hole.
Well, this is getting ugly right now. I mean, he's giving up hit after hit after hit. This offense has clearly figured him out. How much longer can you leave him in to take a beating?
Up now, their second baseman.
But Gary, he struggles with runners on base, so look for them to go right at him at the plate.
One out with runners at first and second. He deals. There's a swing, line drive, center field. And he's on now. That's going to be another hit for them.
Well, now after giving up three straight hits, the manager has to start thinking about getting somebody up in the pen.
Fletcher batting now, and the bases are loaded for him.
And I tell you what, they've been swinging the bat so well in this game. One more hit right here, and this thing is over.
This is a big lead already. And starts him out here. First pitch, a slider for a called strike.
When in doubt, go down and away. He throws the slider exactly where he wants to. Tough pitch to hit.
He delivers. Oh, and he lays off the fastball. Good pitch, 1-1.
Well, anytime you have a good fastball and you can keep it down in the zone, around the knees or lower, it's great location and, believe me, very difficult to hit.
Fastball gets away from him there, 2-1. The 2-1 pitch. Won't permit on that hard slider, now 3-1.
Well, he works the count to 3-0, and this is a hitter right here. You don't have to nibble and try to hit the corners. Throw it over the middle of the plate with good stuff. More than likely, you'll get him out.
Back there in deep left center. Two away. That'll keep the sacks full.
Now back for the Los Angeles Angels of Anaheim.
In the box, their third baseman. And he needs to come through here with two down.
Infield got to play back in this situation and get the out at the easiest base.
Two outs, bases loaded. Here we go, here's the first pitch. He sends this one in the air towards center. That one's grabbed, side retired. Only load the bases on the strength of three base hits, but no run. And we'll see the Astros coming up next. Out of the order, due to bat next. And the first baseman in. He bounced out his last time.
Well, this is a good move right here. You're bringing in the better defensive player. Defense helps you win games.
Swing and a drive, deep left center. And Trout gets to it.
Nice if, you know, win it big right now. You just want to go out there, make plays, throw strikes, force them to try to put multiple hits together to get back into this game.
Now batting with one away, Josh Reddick. Lifetime, he's picked up no hits in one at-bat off the Angels. Here's the first pitch. Swings at that fastball and misses, 0-1.
Well, just because he's a fastball hitter doesn't mean you can't throw him a fastball. Strength on strength right there, and the pitcher came out ahead.
On the way. Hit in the air. This one's going well into the stands, off to the right.
Foul ball!
The pitch, and Josh Reddick goes down swinging. That's strike three.
Well, that's what you love to see from a pitcher, setting guys down quickly. Keeps that pitch count down.
1-2-3, can't ask for any more efficiency than that, John.
No, an excellent pitch selection there.
And we've got Stubbs here. He's coming in to take his hacks here. And a fly ball, and this could be it. And you just saw it, folks. That's going to be the last play of this game.
Well, the Angels win this one handily. They showed up the play and made it look easy at the end.
Come to that point where we take a look back and say, who made a difference? Here's our player of the game.
Well, anytime you have three legs of the cycle, you know you've had a decent enough game to help your team win. Look, would he have loved to hit the triple to get the cycle, something that's rarely done in Major League Baseball? Sure he would. But I think if you ask him after the game, he's going to say, look, all I want to do is help our team win. And that's what he did with those big, big hits.
Steve, it seemed like they knew from the get-go they had it. This was going to be their day, and they were right.
You and I like the close games just because there's a little more intrigue for all nine innings, but the hometown fans, they like the offensive explosion and the big win.
So glad you could join us. For Steve Phillips and John Kruk, I'm Gary Thorne. We'll see you real soon.